church. We're going to see you guys later in a little bit. So my title today is Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. And it comes from Colossians chapter 1, 27. And that says, God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery, which is Christ in You. Sound like a Palm Sunday verse. But I think, I hope by the end we'll see where I'm coming with that. So, today is Palm Sunday. Today is a day that we celebrate. Just like the crowd of Jesus' disciples as he entered Jerusalem. And in our unison reading, we read about what they said. They said, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. He even says that after that, the kids were running around the temple shouting, Hosanna to the Son of David. And it really made the priests angry. And it just, while we're in Sunday school, Kylie and Ari aren't here, but Kylie is there. They were singing a Hosanna song, a jumping up and down song that is a great song that we experience at camp. But it just made me think of that, the kids exclaiming about Hosanna. Just think about what that day was like. Just think about what would it have been like to join that parade into the city. Because it was the beginning of the Feast of Passover. And Passover was a time when they were remembering God's triumph over their oppressors in Egypt. God bringing them out of slavery. God's care for them, really establishing his a nation to worship him. Jacob's family went to Egypt and was like 12 brothers. And they left as 12 tribes, like a million people. It was a nation that was set apart to be, praising God, to be the worshipers of God. That's what they were celebrating. And it was a time in these feasts for people to come to town because the place to celebrate Passover was at the temple. It was kind of like March Madness. That was the place to be. Or maybe it's like being at Disney on spring break, right? So it's the place to be. But this Passover in particular, they were celebrating the presence of the Messiah and his coming for victory. Christ, the Messiah, the one that they had hoped for, that they had recognized as that one that was prophesied that he was going to be there, he was coming to Jerusalem for Passover. They just knew this was a big event. We sing Hosanna. We celebrate the indwelling of Christ in us, our Savior and King. Uh, because this was a culmination of events that had started at Jesus' birth. If we look back at the first page of the New Testament, in Matthew chapter 1, we read about the angel's message to Joseph. And he said, or it says, but he, that's Joseph, had considered this. And then, which is, Mary was pregnant, right? So he was considering this. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife. Because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. So, the angel came to give the promise of God with us. So just as a kind of, maybe this is a rabbit hole, I don't know, but just consider, put yourself in Joseph's shoes for a minute. Does what the angel just said to you make any sense? Can a virgin really conceive? Can a baby that Mary's going to give birth to be God? How can this baby be the Son of God and the Son of Man at the same time? It's really a mystery. It seems comfortable for us to talk about it because we've always heard it that way. It's just what we know. But I think if we spend some time and contemplate, how do we react to this? How would Joseph react to this? We're people that value science and reason. We're forced to embrace the mysterious. The mystery of a baby being born in a simple village to simple people is going to be, or is, God with us. And God with us will save us and will save his people from their sin. And Jesus, early in his ministry, has this conversation with Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a prominent teacher. He was one of the leaders in the synagogue. And so he comes to Jesus like at night when nobody will notice and starts asking Jesus questions. He's curious. He wants to know. And in John 3:3 says, Jesus replied, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless they are born again." How can someone be born when they're old? Nicodemus asked. Surely they cannot enter a second time in their mother's womb and be born. And then in verse 14, it goes on. This is Jesus speaking, and it says, "Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him." Again, this is just sort of the bread and butter of our lexicon of Christianity. And we don't appreciate how weird it sounded to Nicodemus. Jesus didn't shame Nicodemus for asking questions. He didn't belittle him for having a hard time understanding. He just continued to help reveal to him, you know, the truth of who he was and what God's plan was. But he did ask Nicodemus to embrace that mystery, that you must be born again. He asks us to embrace the mystery. What does that mean? What is it mean to be born again? So, getting back to Holy Week. We see the crowd in Jerusalem that was celebrating Christ coming to them. They shouted, "Hosanna to the Son of David." Literally translated, Hosanna means save us. Just like the praise song we sang, right? God save us. And when they were saying to the Son of David, it's an acknowledgement that Jesus is the Messiah. Jesus is the Son of David, the King, the coming King, David, the King, the one that was close after God's heart, their icon of the past. Because they had gotten this figured out. This was Emmanuel. This is God with us. God is with us, and he's coming to town today. Just as we heard in, we read from Psalm 24 this morning about open up the doors, you know, the ancient gates, the King of Glory is about to come in. You know, they had to be thinking about those Psalms of the King is on his way. They're saying Hosanna to the Son of David. It's like they're inviting him. Messiah, come save us. And I think they absolutely understood correctly who he was and what he was doing. He, Jesus, is the Messiah, and he was on a mission to save them and us. The way he went about it was unexpected and something that could not be explained or planned with human logic. It was Passover when they celebrated Moses standing up to Pharaoh. And then what happened? God buried Pharaoh's army in the bottom of the Red Sea. You know, God defeated the superpower and they didn't even have to fight. Right? You know, this is our King of Glory has come to town and he's going to save us. The King of Glory, strong and mighty, mighty in battle, but who was arrested and executed by his oppressors. It's another part of the mystery. How does this work? If you're the conquering king, how do you just give yourself over to execution? So, as we celebrate Palm Sunday, we welcome the King of Glory to our town. We invite him to be with us. We celebrate that he saves us here and now, just the same as he did then. So, let the King of Glory come in. So, as I was meditating on this thought of the King of Glory, you know, and welcoming the King of Glory, it reminded me of this verse from Colossians 1:27. And, excuse me, I need a cough button. The verse says it's a mystery, and it's always been kind of a mystery to me. You know, how am I supposed to understand that God has made known among the Gentiles this in the glorious riches of his mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Christ in you, the hope of glory. I really love the phrase, but I'm not sure it's one of those mysteries. We can sort of understand it, but maybe we can never completely, in our humanness, understand it. So, again, as I was drawn to that, I found this sermon. Started the music. world hears it as it becomes articulate through us. His perfect harmonious tune is played out on the instrument of each individual Christian life. His church becomes an orchestra bringing a symphony of sweet love, comfort, and peace into our neighborhoods. And I know some of you are going to say, I feel like I'm in the midst of chaos and noise and a battle. You know, that's my experience a lot more than a symphony hall, right? And there are days when we honestly wonder, where is the promise of Jesus coming? You know, and just like Jesus didn't get down on Nicodemus for having questions and having doubts and not being understand is not sin. It's just a reason to press in and find that answer in our heart. So when we face human agony, when we're weighed down by the suffering of humanity, Christ in me says, I know pain just like yours. I grew up in a small town where there wasn't much hope or much opportunity. I wept at the death of my friends. My friends abandoned me. I walked the way of the cross all by myself, alone, even abandoned by God, if God can abandon himself. But out of my cross and suffering, there sprang the light and the glory of resurrection morning. We have the hope of eternity spent with Christ, and just as real is the sweet song of the faithful peace of Christ that guards our heart and mind, even in the midst of pain. Christ in me is the hope of glory. The promise of eternal rest with him and the hope of our endeavor for today. The hope of making a difference not just inside me, but for others around me. Christ energizes the here and now, the present. Christ is in me, and Christ in me is the hope of glory. He is the hope of glory that at last wrongs will be righted. He is the hope of glory that tyrannies will be broken. He is the hope of glory that despotisms will be spoiled. He's the hope of glory that humanity will be delivered. The hope of glory that hungry people will have something to eat. And the hope of glory that lonely people will have a friend to talk to. The hope of glory that those who grieve will have comfort. Because Christ is our hope of glory. That Walton and Delaware County will hear the sweet music of the hope of glory. They will hear that sweet music even before they know where it's being played. Christ in me means the power in me to help bring Christ's calling to pass. This was a statement that really got me, that Christ in me means the power to help bring Christ's calling to pass, and I am a renegade if I sit still and listen to his singing and do not cooperate with his effort. Christ is our hope of glory. He is Walton's hope of glory, and he's singing his song in your heart so that everybody can hear it. Kylie, you want to go invite our kids back in? Because we're gonna play with palms today, and I'm excited because we we talked about handing them out earlier in the service, like maybe we do it during the first hymn. But John said, well, you know, what's going to go on? I said, well, yeah, you know, if I had one and I was sitting behind Richard, I'd be tickling his ears or, you know, and not paying attention. So, because, there might be other ADD people around like me, we waited till the end. So, but as we take the palms, we're going to sing a song of Hosanna. And I want that song, as we sing about loud Hosanna to Christ, that's our commitment to cooperate with the indwelling power of Christ. Jesus called us to abide in the vine. So, as we go through this Holy Week, let's commit to create some time to spend quietly with God. Read the gospel account of Jesus' death and resurrection. Let the power of the mystery of Christ in you soak into the parts of your soul where logic and language fail. But that part of your soul where the reality of Christ in you nourishes your friendship with the Almighty. Listen for the song of Christ as it is played in your soul and in the soul of others. Be empowered by the confidence that Christ is in you and that he is the hope of glory. And that Christ is in you is the hope of glory in your neighborhood. Christ in you is the hope of glory in your schoolroom. Christ in you is the hope of glory at the place where you work. Christ in you is the hope of glory as you walk around playing Pokemon Go on the street. Okay? Christ in you is the hope of glory wherever it is that he puts you. So, Kylie and the kids and the other adults from Junior Church are, while we sing our last hymn, number 172, Hosanna, Loud Hosanna, we're going to have the kids hand out palms, and so let's sing.
Oh, love me and come rain.
So, go with Christ in you, your hope of glory, the hope of glory for all mankind, for all the places you go. Take Christ with you. Sing his song.